Before going to the object-oriented programming language, we have to learn what is procedural-oriented programming. An example of procedural-oriented programming is C. Okay? So, first of all, in procedural-oriented programming, there will be some list of instructions for a computer to follow. And the similar tasks are grouped to form a function. Okay, similar tasks are grouped to form a function, and also there is a drawback, that means the data are publicly available. Since the data are publicly available, there is no data privacy in the case of the procedural oriented programming. But in the case of the object oriented programming, that is in C++, here there is an approach that provide a way of modularizing program, that means the program is divided into small modules. And this module consists of a partitioned memory area for both data and function. That means the data and functions are protected within a partitioned memory area in the case of OOPs, and it is known as the class. And by creating some class, we can create some object also. So what is the difference between class and object? Suppose we can think of a class as a sketch of a house. It contains all the details about the floor, doors, windows, etc. Based on this description, we build the house, and house is the object. Whereas the class is a plan of that house, whereas the object means it is the house is the object. The plan is class, whereas that object is the house. So there is a difference between the class and object. Class is a usually it is a user defined data type. Okay, so the user defined data type, we already know most of the user defined data types, and class is also another data type which is defined by the user. And this class contains, in addition to the data, it can hold some functions also. That's why class create a partition memory area for the data and function, where the data is known as the data members and the members are known as the member functions. Also, the data can be stored in a private manner also, so that the data can be hidden. Okay, and this can be accessed by creating object. The class is accessed by creating the object. Okay, and the data members are the data variables, and the member functions are the functions used to manipulate these variables. And together, these data members and member functions define the properties and behavior of the objects in a class. Okay. So we already know that this class is a user defined data type, and the keyword is class, and this is a class name which is a user defined name. And within a class there will be some access specifier which we will learn later. That is, access specifier means we can declare our data members and member functions as private, public or protected, which is absent in the case of the procedure oriented programming. And the data members means the variables to be used, member functions means the method to access the data members. And here the class name end with a semicolon. Here we have to notice a semicolon is there. So this is how a class is declared. For an object, we already know that it is an instance of a memory, right? Instance of a class, right? And when a class is defined, no memory is allocated. But when an object is created, the memory is allocated. And declaring the object, how we will declare an object? The class name and the object name. Class name means, after the keyword we will specify a class name, right? And it is a class name, and we will put some object name. That is how we will declare the object. Let's look upon a simple example how this class work. Suppose we have to store the ID, age and name of 50 students in a data, right? And there we have to enter the ID, name and age, and we have to see this in a separate manner, like when we call someone, we have to see that person's ID, age and name. For that, we will create a class, and that is a keyword class, and the class name is student. And inside this, we will declare the ID, age, and also we will declare the function as public. Since we declare the function as public, that means void read data. That means when we declare some functions as public, it can be accessed outside the class also or outside the program. And there is a function that is void read data. Read data means we have to read this information like ID, age and name. That means cout enter the ID, and we have to give the input as ID, cout enter the name and input as name, cout enter the age, cin age. Now, another function is called, which is void display. That means what we have entered, the ID, name and age, and we have to see. We have to see, in order to see, we have to give it to output. See out ID, see out name and see out age. Since we have to see all this in a new line, we are providing here with this n slash. And the ID is stored in here and name is stored and age is stored. Like, because the ID, name and age are the variables which is used to store these values, and this should be given here. Okay. And now in the main function, there will be, we are creating an object, very important. Here we are creating the object. So this is the object. This is the object. And object is declared as class name object. And our class name is student, right? This is class, which is a keyword, and the class name is student. And object can be declared as class name and object name. And in order to access each function, that is, if for reading the input of, or for reading the ID and name as well as the age of the student A, we have to write like this. That is A dot, that is the object dot, first object dot the read data. Object dot read data, that means the pointer will be here and we will read the data's ID, name and age of the A student. Now A dot display means we will enter here and A student's name, ID, name and age will be displayed here. So this is for read data purpose and this is for display function. So this is a function call, right? So object dot function name, that means we are moving here and we are calling that function, and now return 0. So if we have to store another student's characteristics, we can declare another object as student B. Now we can access the read data as B dot read data. We can display it by B dot display, and now return 0. So this is a basic idea about how a class and object is. Usually the class is means what? It is a user-defined data type, and it contains some data members and member functions. And the instance of this class is object. We can remember it with the example of this plan and building. The plan is class, whereas the plan contains a lot of things like data members, member functions, like windows, doors, floor. So that means there will be numerous things. But the object means the real world application. That means the class is there, but by accessing the, by initiating the object, we can access the members of the class. Okay, and there will be the data variables and all the member functions will be there, right? And this is the basic thing about the class and objects. Okay, so thank you.